I was in such a poor way that I hadn't changed my clothes for about 6 months and I hadn't washed, all those sort of things. And you just get so used to it in the end, you don't realise how far you've gone down. One November day, I was absolutely drenched, I had holes in my shoes, and somebody said to me, why don't you go to St. Petrocks? So I went to St. Petrocks, and within 3 hours, they got me in bed and breakfast.
I was brought in to help to house people that were homeless into private rented accommodation. Some of our clients have had issues with drug and alcohol. And even though they are now on the correct path and they are really positive and motivated for change, the landlords don't see that.
We have to offer different options and different models of housing. And what we can do is take that risk and say, we're going to help you. If it fails, it fails. We'll try again. We'll always give people other chances. And we try and give them control over their lives, because people in control, you know, they move forward so much faster.
We provide a lot of support, really, with getting people initially into their properties. We will help them with the rent in advance. And quite often we will say, look, we'll pay half if you'll pay half back. And that actually helps with them budgeting, and it could take them 2 years to pay back £200. But, you know, at least they feel that they are sort of, you know, paying their way a little bit, really.
I think if I didn't come across Petrocks, I think that I don't really know where I'd be. It was either very much, I got told that the children would be rehoused and I wouldn't, so I think that I would have been separated from the children. So I think without the support from Petrocks, Transitions and everybody that's pulled together, I wouldn't be here with my children today within the house. Darren, you'll get me on that.